Welcome back to the Stream Safari video series. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about habitats and microhabitats at the stream and at the river where you may find, hopefully, find macroinvertebrates along with other living creatures within the stream. So in the previous videos, Megan mentioned what a habitat is. And a habitat is a place where something lives, where it is provided food, shelter, protection, nutrients, and things to find and eat that it needs in order to survive. Every living thing requires something specific within its habitat in order for it to call that place its home. And even macroinvertebrates, those water insects, have very specific requirements within a stream ecosystem that it needs in order to survive. Many macroinvertebrates like fast-moving cold water high up in the mountains. Some like very slow, stagnant, polluted water in order for it to survive. It prefers that, actually. Some of the macroinvertebrates like to live along the surface of the river, and that's where it calls its home. So within a river or within a stream as a larger habitat, there's these tiny little microhabitats. And I'm gonna show you what some of those are. That still water there has formed a pool. A pool is non-moving water. This water is still and deep, and in these spots within the stream, all the little fine sand and silt and sediments have collected at the bottom. And this is where we can find some organisms that like to burrow down in there, such as midge larvae, or mayfly nymphs, or even aquatic worms. There is a macroinvertebrate using the surface of this pool within the river as its microhabitat. And that to me actually looks like either a water boatman or a whirligig. We'll have to go get our net to try and see which one it is. But we call this riffles. Riffles upstream in the sun. And then as we pan downstream, we have more. So the largest variety of aquatic insects or macroinvertebrates can be found in these riffles. It's where the stream tumbles over those rocks and it's much more fast moving. There's more oxygen in these places, and therefore can harbor a lot more life. There's also a lot of rocks present in these places where the macroinvertebrates can live under and on. And very often, if you pick up any rock in a healthy ecosystem, you can find mayfly nymphs, water pennies, even caddisfly larvae. And even a single rock can be considered a microhabitat. Hopefully you can see clumps of leaves. And even those are microhabitats. We call those leaf packs. All of these leaves will just gather in clumps, and you can stick your hand or your net right in there and pull out numerous types of macroinvertebrates, including cranefly larvae and small stonefly nymphs. And in a future video, we actually will show you how to make your own leaf pack so that you can put one out in a stream and find macroinvertebrates. And so why do we need to know this? Well, in all the numerous occasions that I've brought children to a stream, the first thing that happens is they come running down the path and they come running down the banks and they're really excited. And the first thing they do is they look at the surface of the water, or they look along the banks and say, I don't see anything. But understanding what the microhabitats are and where potentially you can find them, where they're hiding and where they might be hunting, that'll bring bigger success, more success for the children that you're bringing to the stream to find these macroinvertebrates.